everything more difficult.
You want me to start over?
No, we're
no, good. We're fine.
We're already 2 minutes into
that's good
clips.
That's good.
There we go.
I guess. Did you format the camera?
No. No, yeah, I did.
Okay.
Hopefully.
Leo! I'm so upset. You're cringing, dude. You're cringing me.
Round 5, Free For All Podcast. We have new mic setup. Hopefully this sounds a little bit better. So, of course, I'm Carson, joined with
Riley.
And
Paul.
Here we are.
I get things. That's you a good twice.
It took 5 weeks, but you nailed it. You nailed the intro.
Yep.
All right, so go ahead and jump right in. Oculus VR. I don't know how you are savvy about VR. I think it's kind of cool. A little bit expensive, though.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
VR is a little bit expensive. What do you think about VR?
Yeah, I don't care for it.
Really?
Nice comments.
I think it's going to be the future.
Because you need a Samsung for it, don't you? Well,
it's time to upgrade anyways, you know what I'm saying?
That's one.
No diss to Samsung, but ugh.
That is one VR idea. That's the Samsung VR where you just put the phone in. But they're like ones that connect to your computer, such as Oculus. And where do a lot of these people like to play their VR headsets or get a chance to play VR headsets? No one?
Continue.
We call phone retailers.
Game conventions. You nailed it, Paul. You got it.
There you go.
Well.
That's a good one, too. Phone retailer. Like dealerships.
For the only Samsung one. And there's a Google one. But so when people use these VR headsets, a lot of people, they end up getting diseases, such as ocular herpes.
Oh. Ocular herpes.
So it's reported that it's a type of herpes simplex virus that goes to the eyes. It's a common viral infection. And apparently amount of people have been getting this disease through using many Oculuses, many people rotating at game conventions.
That is gross. They don't clean it afterwards?
I'm pretty sure they just didn't think they had the problem. So,
Why would they think about that?
Yeah, that's true.
When people are touching game controllers, like, I'm pretty sure they don't disinfect that stuff. Like, that's that's just as, like, more disgusting as the next thing. That's
is there, like, an outbreak of it? Or is it just, like, two people like, oh, I got herpes?
It says the National Eye Institution, didn't know that was a thing, says an estimated 400,000 Americans have experienced some form of ocular herpes, with close to 50,000 new and reoccurring cases occurring each year. So this is a little bit of a problem.
Yeah, a little bit.
I mean,
that's
makes
a lot. That's more than I would have thought.
Yeah.
I thought it was like maybe like 1,000 here. That's a good chunk.
I didn't think this was actually going to be a problem. I mean, I guess that's how you get germs. That's how it works, right? You pass things off and it happens. It makes me a little bit more cautious now if I would go to a game convention and like, hey, want to put on this sweaty Oculus? I'm like, maybe not this time.
You just have to clean it. What's
They
eye boogers and shit and like. Ugh.
They said
what if somebody just got over pink eye? Like, you know, they think it's good. They're like, I got rid of it 2 days ago. Let me really go to this game convention. They put it on.
That's not all the way gone.
I mean, I would hate that. Like, man, this game's awesome, but I left with herpes.
I left with herpes. I love this shit. Yeah,
greatest game ever. Gave me herpes.
They say it looks like regular herpes. You get like. Sores like around your eyes and stuff. Yeah, that's not good.
That isn't good.
I mean,
I wouldn't know a lot about herpes though.
I wouldn't.
I don't.
You don't know a lot?
No, because I've never gotten it before.
I would. You've never got ocular herpes.
None of us have
Never got any type of herpes.
None of us.
I mean, herpes are once you get it, right?
I don't know.
That's not all herpes. That. No.
For some people's cases, I would hope they wouldn't have it forever.
And there's no cure.
There's no cure for any known viruses or diseases on Earth.
That's how it works.
May I add, my high school science teacher would like to blast that into people's faces. For many other things.
I mean, it's kind of a scary thought.
It is. That's weird. Well, I mean, just don't use nasty VR sets.
That's the whole thing. Like, just clean it afterwards. I see this as like. It got to the point where it is, and then now people are like, oh, we have to clean it. And then it's just going to not be a thing anymore, I think. I mean, there'll be still cases, but not 50,000.
Yeah. No, yeah. Wait, how many cases were reported?
It was 400,000.
Oh, 400,000.
And then 50,000 reoccurring or new each year.
Wow. And it's...
Yeah.
I don't know about that. What source is this?
Allaboutvision.com.
.com?
No, I feel like they're using those statistics. They're not all from VR sets. I would
that,
think.
You know, that might be a thing. 50,000
people are getting...
Yeah, that's a lot.
How many people have eye herpes and are using VR sets like for that to go around?
We're not very professional source. But we have TheVerge.com says, and that's a legit source. As of 2010, over half of 18 to 49-year-old Americans tested positive for HSV-1, which is behind the bulk of ocular herpes cases. So it's still a problem.
Gross.
I mean, this is not something just to ignore.
Yeah.
So you just don't test it.
I mean...
they first got aware of on October 24th of 2016 when someone tweeted, eye herpes is spreading via VR headset. You know those big events where people try VR for the first time? Well, those devs got herpes from it.
Devs?
Devs.
The devs got herpes?
Yes.
Well,
this dev got herpes from it. So he's saying that he got it.
Oh, he got it. Ooh.
So from there, it kind of, that got like 1,000 retweets and about 1,000 likes.
Well, if you were a germaphobe, I wouldn't even think that people would use that stuff.
I can't imagine I don't think it'd be a big deal, but now that I'm thinking about it, if you put on the headset and it's squishy and sweaty. That happens. Imagine you're the 45th person putting on that.
Oh no, there's way more people than that. If it's at a convention, you think it's hundreds.
Face and shit.
Yeah.
That's not good.
I mean, I think it's gross when people have phones and they're passing the call and you see the screen is all
it's all greasy.
You gotta wipe it off real quick.
Especially females. I'm not trying to diss you, but my mom and my sister, if I ever get a phone call and they're like, here, this is so and so, I look at the screen and it's just like, you can't even fucking read the words.
that's pretty bad.
They're clean people, but you can't help how much grease is builds up on your face.
Oh,
no matter how many times you clean your face.
Now, if you're online out there and you're in a VR headset experience and you see someone in particular that's really sweaty or something,
don't try that. At least clean it up. They don't clean it at all.
They say that...
just a wipe.
Yeah. They're going to take higher precaution and wipe down and spray it every time someone uses it.
Yeah, good, yeah.
But that hasn't stopped the 400,000 people.
Or get your own.
Get your own. No, headsets are expensive.
How about just avoid people with herpes?
How much is a VR headset?
Okay, here's the thing.
I can get a cardboard one online for $5.
That's not the same thing.
That's not the same.
I could get.
You might not know everything about headsets. how much is the Oculus? $400?
I don't know. I know it's expensive.
$400, $500?
Is that the one where you can see your video games through, or what?
Well, they have tailored games to the VR. Like actual VR games. It's not just an experience. There's actual games to it. And I think it's $500, but you have to have an $800 PC to be able to run it.
Fuck.
So yeah, it's pretty, if you want to get one, go ahead.
Which is the one with the full setup? Has the full platform, you need a whole room for the HTC Vibe? Is that it?
I think so. That one beat Oculus a whole bunch because Oculus was really late on the release and stuff. And that one just came as hey-o, I'm here. Still expensive. Still really expensive.
That one's pretty cool, though.
I think you just got to let a couple of years go by before they start going down.
I don't know if VR's more of a fad or if it's actually going to stick around because it seemed to hit pretty hard how a fad would hit. But and now it seems like the practicality of it's kind of...
I think it's going to go further.
I don't know.
Do you think this is the nail in the coffin for VR? Herpes?
No, I just don't think it's going to blow up iPhone would blow up or anything.
I think it already did blow up. Blew up in 2014 and 15.
Yeah, I can see it going, because it's not just games and stuff. They're using it for
The VR that I hear about is the one with the phone in it, or I see some of these newspaper companies, you can buy a VR set or a cardboard and put your phone, you can see multimedia stories on it. I don't really hear much about gaming or the other high-end VR sets. I always see the Samsung one advertised.
Well, that one's more the casual one. I don't think Oculus did really do a marketing campaign for their VR headset.
It was all word.
It was all word. It's people who know this. It's more of the hardcore industry people. That's probably why you didn't know anything about the Oculus price or anything like that. Or even
which brings me to my point. Goes back to I don't think it's going to be blowing up in people's faces.
Yeah. I don't even think the Samsung thing really isn't getting that big. Or the Google Dream.
The Samsung one is pretty big. I think it is. Samsung VR. Do they have a patent on that? Because I'm surprised Apple hasn't come out with anything similar.
Google did the Dream. What was it called? Daydream, which is their.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, it's just like the Samsung VR.
I wonder why Apple hasn't stepped up their game. Usually they're all like, "Oh, we got something better."
Yeah, they think they would.
They're
like,
probably working on it. For all we know.
What was the last invention they've had? There's the watch, right? That was the last big thing they released?
The Apple, yeah. They're coming out with a red iPhone. I don't know if that's true or not, but...
Red?
Oh, I heard about that, yeah.
A red iPhone 7. Kind of cool. I want it. It's dope.
We'll see in 6 months.
Speaking of a website you can buy a VR headset, possibly riddled with herpes, eBay has just...
Good segue.
Just guaranteed... delivery for 3 days or less.
Like Amazon?
It says, unlike Amazon Prime, guaranteed delivery is available to shoppers at no additional costs.
Oh, really? That's okay.
And eBay claims that...
That's a hard promise.
It is. And
a lot of things that I've gotten... The majority of things that I've been getting on eBay, and I don't shop on eBay a lot because I'm an Amazon Prime member. And no product placement. But... Anyways.
Please sponsor us.
Please. The things that I bought on eBay, they're coming from China.
Yeah.
So those things come on a boat.
Yeah, things on eBay.
I get my stuff in like a month almost.
Things on eBay usually buy are used, and the person who's like selling it has to guarantee to get it in there, or it's like from really far away.
Is it guaranteed with all packages, or a certain it says
package? That is crazy that they're promising that. That's
something I
don't
never
even like
think.
eBay, though. Like as a Like,
I haven't bought much stuff off of eBay.
Nah.
I don't really buy anything off eBay.
eBay is like the Craigslist of...
Ooh.
Yeah.
eBay was the big thing.
I agree with that.
Yeah, right?
He's like, you can buy this used thing off of eBay, or you can go to Amazon and get guarantee. And
my dad got...
Even though we just bought one of the lapel mics from Amazon and it came broken.
What lapel mic?
The one on your shirt.
Oh, I thought our audio was coming out magically professional.
No. Oh, it is professional.
Yeah. It was broken.
Way to ruin it.
Yeah, we let people know that we have a problem.
Gosh.
They can see.
They don't see it. Stop
they know
it.
How it works.
Anyways, yeah, my father, he got like an iPod when they were a big thing, the little, what are they called, Nanos?
Oh, yeah.
He got one when it was a big thing, maybe like back in 05, and when he got it, he thought it was legit, and it was a total... Chinese
rip off.
So bad. The screen was terrible. So it was just like, yeah, I wouldn't trust anything off.
That's true. You hear stories on that from eBay all the time. Like where someone bought an iPhone for like $50 and they thought they got a deal, but it's like a picture. Like someone printed a picture. That happens all the time.
Yeah, it's literally the Craigslist of online. Like,
yeah.
It's like,
you know, Craigslist is an online thing.
Well, like you have to go meet the guy.
Yeah.
This one's like they can send you a brick for a phone.
Yeah.
Which has happened. It says that eBay claims that more than 220 million items on this site qualifies for the service. Many of those already come with free shipping. And the new program basically gives a guaranteed date for when shoppers can expect their purchases to arrive. If a guaranteed delivery item misses its delivery date, buyers can have their shipping costs refunded.
Ooh.
That's pretty good.
But
so,
still get the thing? Their product?
Yes.
Ooh.
So it's really... Like, I don't get it. It's like... There's nowhere saying that it does it like not work with people who are selling stuff like.
So you have to be a trusted.
Probably.
Company, maybe.
Probably.
Yeah.
And then again, I don't think I've ever seen a company sell things on eBay.
Yeah.
Have you seen?
Yeah. Some.
Really?
They have ratings and stuff where like how trustworthy they are and stars.
I don't think we're calling like I've seen like Apple sell their things on eBay or.
Oh no!
Like,
big companies I can see.
Like, I know Amazon does. Right? Amazon does that stuff?
I was thinking more like small
they
companies.
Actually have companies sell through their
Amazon has like little like local based companies that like guarantee like that will ship their product. So yeah, I don't know if you probably either have to be like really like good rating person that sells stuff to like apply for this or it doesn't apply for people selling stuff at all.
I mean, I get 1 day free shipping from Amazon, so
that's how we got the broken mic back so fast.
Oh, we got those in 2 days.
How's eBay doing? I haven't really heard anything from eBay.
The late 2000s.
Yeah.
So they were. I remember when they were a big thing.
They were huge.
They were like, I remember Amazon being a nobody, and now Amazon's like 2010.
Last time I paid attention to eBay was for a joke that a YouTuber H3H3 used when he tried to sell his beanie for $77 million.
See, and that's another thing about eBay.
It's a joke.
You can sell anything at any price, yeah. And people will do it.
It was a joke anyway. He didn't really sell it, but the point is, he's not using eBay as it's intended because no one really cares. Yeah. You know?
But people do. People buy things for outrageous amounts.
Why don't we think about this, the people that didn't get it on launch have to get it now, like we'll pay $300 more than it's actually called.
Like I've seen jerseys being sold.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
The Nintendo Switch.
Limited, very limited things people sell on eBay. That's what eBay was used for. Mm-hmm. Like you weren't there to get it,
A lot of shoe enthusiasts will do that. Yeah. They'll sell their Jordans or the Supreme drop will come out.
Just electronics.
Yeah, a lot of the Xbox One and PS4 was a big thing.
You couldn't trust what you're getting. You might have just gotten the box.
Yeah. And then he would have gone.
Never, dude. Never, ever.
That's pretty sketchy.
I gotta admit, though, the last time I used eBay was for Christmas, and that's because I intended getting something from Asia. I got my sister, because she's really into K-pop. So I got her a South Korean artist, and that took a long time. It was legit, got the real thing, because I knew, how could it be fake and a rip-off?
Fake and rip-off?
Yeah, like, so, if you want sketchy things, I guess through eBay.
Ooh.
It says, in addition to a guaranteed 3-day delivery window, eBay will also allow shoppers to filter search results with 1 or 2-day delivery options.
Ooh.
The main difference being eBay's program and Amazon Prime is Amazon Prime's $99 annual subscription. Qualifying items ship at a no added cost. eBay. Wait,
so you don't need to be a member to get these things?
No, he's just pretty much like eBay was like, I got to put in the computer charger. So, it's like eBay's like pretty much like, you know what, we're guaranteeing 3 days because we're dying, you know?
Yeah, I can see that, where they're like, hey, we have to step our game up a little bit.
We're professionals.
I really want to know how they're doing as a company. That's my big thing right now. Because if they are going down, I can see why they're doing this then.
I don't know.
I would have thought they would have members only type thing.
It says eBay is marketing the delivery guarantee program to sellers by saying that it will attract new buyers and that existing customers will be happier.
I can see where that could be a good thing, though, for college students, because I know a lot of people who are desperate for cheaper textbooks.
Oh, yeah.
They
go to eBay, and if you need that textbook for a class, like, the next day, hey, or the next couple of days, by all means, eBay. And how can you be sketchy selling a textbook? So,
yeah,
I think that's a good thing for eBay, I guess, for on that part. Yeah. College students.
Switching from eBay to YouTube, Google, Alphabet. That's technically the company name. I don't know if you knew that.
Yeah.
Alphabet.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's like Google's a branch of Alphabet.
Yeah, I know. Oh. That Alphabet's logo looks almost exactly like Google's.
I have no clue about that. Like, I'm learning stuff.
The font and everything.
Oh,
yeah, so I got that article. So apparently Google apologized to these major brands that were showing their advertisements on YouTube because these major companies were like, hey, we don't want our advertisements being showed on racist content or derogatory stuff. So they got mad and they pulled out their advertisements from YouTube, and Google was like, oh, we apologize. But I mean, what do you guys think? Like, what steps can Google take to prevent that or make these companies it's very hard, right?
I don't think Google can take any steps to this to prevent it. I think it's just what it is.
Mm-hmm.
And even personally, whenever I saw an ad before a video, I never connected the two.
Yeah.
It was always separate to me, like, Ford, and then I watched, like, I don't know, H3H3 or something.
Yeah.
It wasn't the same.
It's like I'm watching, like, World Star or Skate Fails. It's not like I saw like an ad for like tampons. I'm like, wow, tampons fucking love Skate Fails.
Yeah, apparently.
It's just I never connect to, but like that's how big corporations are. They just connect their brand to stuff that their products are shown on. But the point of YouTube is it's you. So yeah. What is YouTube or Alphabet going to do?
It's almost, it looks like this article is saying that it's all almost based in Europe. All these European companies, companies like Audi, McDonald's, which is really not European, but it's there. McDonald's and Audi have redacted their advertising from UK platforms. Like, I guess only UK, in the UK.
So UK's the one, or their
UK's pulling
the
out?
Products in UK are the only ones that are really.
UK's pulling out. It says McDonald's and Audi and the UK government have already stopped using the platforms in the UK. So I don't know if it's because of the spike in terrorist attacks that have happened in Europe. So they're like, well, it's sensitive times, especially London having that terrorist attack just a couple of days ago. So, but this happened before that. So I don't know. I mean, I guess the biggest thing Google can do is just apologize. You can't really filter what's going to be on. That's almost impossible.
You have to think that the people who put these ads on YouTube know what they're signing up for. You know, they can't just act oblivious like, oh, wait, you're saying that the internet's not it's not perfect? You're saying that there are people that say things I don't agree with or are exactly family friendly on YouTube?
Yeah.
And you got to know what you're signing up for, buddy.
I mean, they've been advertising this stuff for years, and YouTube's always been like this. They've always showed unfiltered, explicit content. So, I mean, I guess it's a loss for these companies.
Yeah, it must be a huge loss for them because they, like, all the videos that they're being viewed on, and now they're just pulling out of that.
Mm-hmm.
But I think
they'll probably come around and be like, shit.
Well, no, I think you did have a point with the whole terrorist situation because they did bring up their videos were on.
Yeah, and that's why these companies are pulling out because of over racist terrorist content.
So I could see that
racist terrorist content.
Yes, that's what.
Not profound.
This is from NBC News.
Because what I'm thinking right now is like the iDubbbz, the Filthy Franks that just curse all the time and they do gross stuff.
A lot of these big YouTubers put stuff out that's really explicit and like edgy and like.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
And some of these companies sponsor these YouTubers. So I don't know. I mean, these companies aren't being little bitches about it because they know that that's who they are. I guess that's the stuff they produce.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think people would be like making connections or like, oh man, this company probably promotes racist stuff.
Exactly. Like, I never made that connection.
No one's gonna think, oh my god, McDonald's is a bunch of racist jackasses.
We just had McDonald's today. Yeah. I don't think you're Nazis.
I support them. You know.
I'm a consumer.
Yeah. I don't see that being a big problem.
I think they pulled out thinking that Google was gonna change it, like fix it for them, but
they don't understand. You
can't do it.
Yeah, they don't understand how that works.
You can't control the content that people produce.
I mean, I guess these companies can choose, like if they really want their advertisement being showed, they get to do they have to do their research though.
If they want to,
like if they want
research.
particular YouTubers. And not just random content. Oh, like if they want their advertisement to be shown on
that's a lot of work though.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know if that's how it works for the advertisement. I think it's.
I mean, I guess that's just sponsoring.
It's yeah.
Pretty much.
It's
huh?
Buyer
you just
beware.
Have to sponsor them.
Yeah. You can do if you're really you know lobby on your lotion or whatever. If you're really concerned about your branding on YouTube, hit up PewDiePie and be like, hey, don't you know? Or hit up.
Didn't PewDiePie get dropped from Disney or
something?
Yeah,
YouTube might be a bad example. But you know, hit up those toy review channels, you know? And they'll be nice.
Tech Destruction
channels, fucking drone, Coca-Cola, meal, like.
Have Coca-Cola sponsor that shit.
Coca-Cola, get into there, man.
Yeah. I mean, I don't really see advertising much because I have YouTube Red. So I can't really.
You have YouTube Red? You're actually paying
for
it?
There you go.
No, I'm not. I am actually
using
someone else's account. No.
Oh. Look at you. Not
illegally though. I know the person. He let me.
YouTube Red is. That's weird too.
But it's funny though because I totally forgot that YouTube Red doesn't have you don't have to look at advertisements. So I was like, you know what? I haven't seen an advertisement on YouTube in a long time.
About it.
And then I saw this thing like, oh yeah, I get exclusive like ad free content. I was like, oh shit.
That's what I got.
I got that. And you can also listen to stuff while your phone is locked or.
Is YouTube Red an ad killer for people like those people who have ads on YouTube?
I know that was
a
huge issue.
I mean, what if it gets big?
I don't think it's going to get... If it was going to get big, it would have got big already.
I mean, look at the audience who watches YouTube. They're relying on YouTube because it's free already. Yeah. They're not going to start paying for stuff. I mean, not to be, like, sensitive, but some of these... The audience, they're low-income people, so they can't really afford paying for YouTube Red, so they got to rely on the it being free.
You're saying that YouTube, the general YouTube audience is?
I'm not... Yeah, like...
I don't think so.
I don't think
they're all like rich, like they can all afford stuff. I mean, people who watch YouTube are probably not. I'm not saying everybody. I'm saying there's probably a good chunk who are not paying for Netflix or Spotify or any of these other stuff, things that you have to pay for to see or listen to these things. And that's why YouTube is a big thing, because they're not paying for this stuff.
Oh, I see where you're coming from. Yeah, it's free content compared to something like Netflix, and especially with how YouTube has grown into like videos that are features like that actually you would want to watch over Netflix. It's no longer like the first video on YouTube where a guy's talking about an elephant in the background, you know? It's actually cool videos that if I had a choice, I'd rather choose YouTube over Netflix.
Ooh.
I would.
That's saying much. Well, that is saying a lot.
I mean, viewers who really like follow the crap out of their YouTubers, mm-hmm. and all these YouTubers are making original content on YouTube, and you only could watch it through YouTube Red, then yeah, these people are gonna be paying for this stuff, and they're like, oh man, I really need to know what they're uploading and stuff.
Yeah,
I can't be out of the blue.
A lot of YouTube channels like Rooster Teeth or once again Funhouse. Funhouse has like two video segments I never knew of that I can't watch because it's on Rooster Teeth first.
Ooh, I'm looks like someone's gonna have to hit me up on my account.
Yeah.
Psych!
No, it's not YouTube Reds. It's Rooster Teeth first. It's like their own thing.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, but either way, it's like stuff like that. YouTube Reds actually coming out with like another movie.
Oh God.
Because Rooster Teeth came out with Laser Team, and now they're doing like a movie that has, oh man, I forgot the guy's name, but he's like a daytime vlogger, YouTuber. He was like colorblind. I don't know if you guys saw the colorblind video.
Oh yeah, something like that.
He's starring in a YouTube Reddit original movie. Have you heard about that?
I haven't heard anything about it.
It's called The Thinning, and the sad part is I kind of like the idea of it if it was done by like Paramount Pictures or Lionsgate, like an actual movie company, you know, but it's fucking YouTube Red.
And it's this actor.
And it's this actor
who lied about being colorblind.
Sort of. I don't know.
Did he lie?
That was a video that H3 exposed. And
if you guys watch it,
iDub exposed the hell out of.
iDubs and H3 watch it. It's colorblind or something.
Something.
I have to watch that.
Yeah. It just points out this guy might not be colorblind.
Because he was...
There was this one video he had. So apparently he's certain colorblind. So he can't like see like green and blue and stuff. He can see some yellow and red. That's what he claims. But he had like a video, one of his videos where he's like, you guys talking about my 400 light set I got in my room? Watch this. Blue, red, green, red. He's named the colors as he clicked the thing and the room would light up.
But then several videos later,
he's like, I'm colorblind.
He got the colorblind glasses and he went to like Griffith Observatory and looked at the sunset and put these glasses. He was like, it's all dramatic. He's
all
like,
dramatic.
Very yeah. cheesy. And like, oh, God.
Either way, that guy is starring in a YouTube Red movie called The Thinning. And it's about every year people take these standardized testing in school. But here's the kicker. If you fail, you die.
Whoa.
So you can get only the intelligent people.
Ooh. That is a good idea.
Yeah, not with him.
not with him, though.
Ooh, diss.
Diss. He
deserved. Actually.
he apparently passes, but his girl doesn't, so he's got to save him. But wait, there might be a conspiracy. Someone rigged the test or something.
What?
Plot twist.
Yeah,
I don't know.
So big advertisers, you know, get up on that money for that movie.
You know that too. Well, no, I just said that YouTube Red doesn't show advertising.
Mm-mm. Yeah, YouTube Red doesn't show it.
I was gonna say they could have showed advertisement. These companies could have showed their stuff on these YouTube Red movies, but fuck, you can't watch them.
There's like three movies out on YouTube Red.
I'm trying to think, like, how could these companies go around it? I mean, you know how people tag their videos? They can look out, they can look at videos.
Look at the tags.
They can
it?
See like if the tags are suitable for their advertisement, I guess.
I mean, I can see that, but once someone figures out like that's their tags, they can just put the tags on anything.
Yeah, I guess so.
That would be an issue.
I really think there's no really way. I think pretty much how it goes is like, company comes up. It's like YouTube, like the company's like, I want to be promoted on YouTube. He was like, okay, here you go. And just goes, boosh, and just goes out. It's in the internet.
Yeah, I think that's in YouTube now.
Yeah. It's like, you know, everything you want, everything on YouTube is fair game.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do.
It's too moral.
I think it's just their law.
The story. I don't think there's anything you can do. I think these companies are just going to have to deal with it.
I think they're doing it because all the terrorism. And if it does calm down eventually.
Because the world has come to a sensitive place.
Yeah, that's true.
Because they link everything to, like, anything.
Social justice warriors.
Offensive.
All that good stuff.
Yeah. They're like, oh.
You saying the,
oh my god.
You saying the world's getting too sensitive?
How dare you show your advertising on this terrorist
on this terrorist video. Organization.
Like, fuck off, dude. Because Audi, like, oh, terrorist video. Then you put the advertisement on that. Like, come on. Put some thinking into the...
This is only happening primarily in the UK, right?
That's what it said. I mean, according to the...
Yeah, it's only happening... It's primarily in the UK, which is a lot of the companies that are pulling out are
British, UK base, yeah. Like three of Britain's biggest banks just removed their ads from Google when they saw their campaigns appearing next to extremist content.
Extremist content. How many people are watching those videos?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Why is that stuff even on YouTube? Like, oh, YouTube bans a lot of things, yeah. And so, like, why is that stuff on?
I know, YouTube's all about
that's pretty easy to filter, right?
You would think.
Probably, I guess not. I guess it's kind of hard.
Unless somebody reports it, huh?
I don't know. The YouTube Hero Program. God, that's terrible.
Is that still a thing?
I hope not.
Explain that. What is that?
YouTube Hero Program is a program where people, actual users, can sign up to flag content, and you get levels and shit. Like,
oh, so you're YouTube police.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh,
that's pretty much it.
And if you get like to a certain level, like level 70 and shit, you can do some nasty shit, like take down a video until YouTube officials actually review it and like or
so
say
you can take someone's video down.
You can take someone's video down if you're like high
that
level.
That can't be a thing anymore.
I hope not.
I know it was a big thing and then no one really talked about it.
Yeah, because people were probably just doing it for the fuck of it.
I don't get why YouTube wouldn't think that. Like, all of our people are
They're loyal. They wouldn't do anything like that.
They like cat videos. What can they do wrong? Apparently everything.
YouTube's great though. We love YouTube.
YouTube's great. It just fucks up a lot.
Yeah, it does.
YouTube fucks
the
up
the age restriction.
Yeah.
Like there's some things out there that don't need to be, but then there's some things out there that definitely need to be age restricted.
Yeah, and they don't do it.
Maybe that's part of the ad. They should be aware of the ad campaign. Maybe that's probably the only filter I can think of. It's like, all right, you can be monetized on everything that isn't age restricted. Even though a lot of videos can get away with a lot of stuff without being able
to. Yeah, exactly. So that's what brings me back to the point. Like, there's nothing you can do. It's almost impossible. Like, Christina was saying how she follows a lot of these LGBTQ
YouTubers,
and they're not doing anything sexual, but they're being age-restricted because
they're not their sexuality.
Yeah,
my whole thing is if they're hiding it from, like, kids or whatever, they have YouTube kids.
True. Hey, you know what? They can hit YouTube kids up.
Yeah, hit YouTube kids.
I guess, right? Nothing,
sure.
Yeah. Nothing slips by YouTube kids,
I'm pretty sure YouTube kids needs tampons.
Maybe, or a new car.
New car? You need an insurance claim.
Mommy, look at this new van.
I just got a mortgage. TurboTax, the guys are floating.
McDonald's would do great on on YouTube Kids.
Oh my god, they should totally do that. You know what? Every advertiser
get fat.
Yeah, every company that wants to do advertisement, just dumb down your advertisements. You know?
Tell your mommy about the new Audi 2017.
Yeah, you know,
everyone's getting it.
If it's beer, be like, it's yummy juice. You can't drink it, but your dad can.
I don't know about yummy juice. That does not sound good to me.
Yeah, but
tell your dad about Bud Light.
Yeah.
Bud Light.
That's BUD.
Spelling it
can
out.
Can you spell Bud?
We'll take a moment for you to take this tablet to your parents.
You know what?
And the person's like, what the fuck?
Yeah. Are you doing it? Are you doing it? You haven't done it yet.
We know.
We're watching you.
That's a big fucking twist.
Moral of the story, don't wear VR headsets because you will get herpes. And
if or you, wear it from somebody you know. Or don't get a VR set at all.
Wipe them off before.
Carry some fucking wipes, dude.
Carry some baby wipes. And if you want to advertise on YouTube, I don't know. Fair game.
Don't be a pussy.
And also, stick to Amazon. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, stick to Amazon. eBay.
Or do you? Do you, boo-boo? All
right. See you guys next
week. No, screw you,
Ooh.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
That happened.